my sister, my cousin, all of them are my cousin.
Hello. Jumbo.
Beyonga. Hello, Ira. Blana lu di alukulua. Di samping nggak kurang na uri alu. Abu biyo. Abu ngirtet.
Ajamit. Ajamit lu kajakon.
Beyonga. Di samping blana lu di alukul noi urkuan.
Ajamit lu kajakon. Pakai gendeng aku bilat tau.
Jesus, she's very happy, even she can't express herself.
I heard about Danaja through a good friend of mine, Deborah Santana. And I also heard that the girls here had no access to dental care. So then we decided to make a program that would cover their needs and would targeting at improving not only their oral health but also their general health.
So first we're going to see where we have black.
So you can see a little bit of pink, not much. Looks like you're doing a really good job.
Now let's clean in the lower, in the inside.
You want to get your floss through the area and then go up and down.
When I brush my teeth, sometimes I feel a lot of pain, which makes me sometimes not to brush my teeth and go to class. Sometimes I can't even concentrate in class because of the pain. Sometimes I miss lessons, so I'd like to have dental care so that I can continue running my day smoothly.
I feel like shy about my breath.
Some breathing gums at times when I'm brushing my teeth and also when I'm flossing.
My teeth are not in a good condition. I don't love the color of my teeth. When I fear smiling when I'm in class because I fear people lowering my self-esteem.
Well, the program, although it's taken 3 years to develop, we've been conducting the program for this last year, and we see dramatic improvement in their oral health. They've really taken it to heart by improving their oral hygiene and now improving their dietary habits as well.
This project has given girls a lot of value, I must say, right from their smiles. But most importantly is the education that they have gotten from it for themselves and what they have taught in their homes during community service.
We go through thorough oral hygiene instruction with them, which is reinforced by the school nurse on a weekly basis.
One of the highlights of our program is the inclusion of the school nurse, who is now trained to be a oral health provider, in the sense that she's following up with the girls while we are not here.
And by appointing one of the girls as a team leader to coach their mentees, their colleagues, to reinforce oral hygiene and good healthy behaviors as well. We also discuss dietary and exercise and emphasize the importance of proper eating, reducing their sugar intake, and proper physical activity. One of the interesting parts of the program also is we train them to be health advocates, to go back to their communities and teach their parents, their siblings, their friends about improving their oral health. And they're also doing this to the schools in the community around the Nanyuki area.
We'll do similar to what we did last time, where Yvonne and I will give a lecture, and then we'll give all the students a toothbrush, toothpaste, some floss, and then individually we can all teach them how to use it properly. You know, I think a lot of it is you, as you've changed your behaviors and you have much better oral hygiene, so you're there to inspire the students to change as well, to improve their health.
You think it's a good idea?
Yes.
It's also given them a lot of self-confidence to go out to the community and teach the others how to improve their oral health in other schools throughout the area and back in their villages to their parents and siblings and friends.
Their self-esteem, they are happier, they smile easy, and the fact that they were able to train others, that is also a benefit to them.
So it's of utmost importance to also involve all the school staff, including teachers, the management, and all the people working in Danaja, also the people working in the kitchen, because they prepare the food. So they can also act as role models to the girls, showing that they themselves they have adopted healthy, good habits.
Being a leader, I have acquired leadership skills, and also personally, I used to have cavities, but now they are filled and my teeth are fine and I no longer have sensitivity.
You know, our vision is really bigger than Daraja, because we'd like the oral health in Kenya to improve throughout the country. So our hope is that we can expand this program beyond this school to other schools, to other regions throughout the country. And it's a very low-cost program, but has had so far a high impact. And to start that off, we've created a book with my colleague Dr. Whiskey as the initiator, something that they could take to their family to help them to improve their oral health.
We have two versions, the English version and the Swahili version.
We hope that this program that we've developed will have a profound impact on improving oral health and general health throughout the country.
It has changed so many people, not only me, not only the Daraja students, but some our members in the community.
You don't have any pain, you're just smiling all the way. You're being happy of your tears.
So my hope is that this project goes on and it continues to impact people. And yes, we're going to change the world.
We are all the same. Even though sometimes we look different, we are not at all. We are all the same. We are all connected. We are one.
And I would love the project to continue because it's impacting the society. Like when we go to help the children in the primary school to learn how to brush their teeth, I would want it not only to be Daraja in the primary school, but also to be Daraja and all other schools in Kenya.